इन पब्लिक इकोनॉमिक्स थ्योरी गुड्स और कमोडिटीज आर ब्रॉडली डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, नंबर वन प्राइवेट गुड्स एंड नंबर टू पब्लिक गुड्स ऑल्सो नोन एज सोशल गुड्स और कलेक्टिव गुड्स. अ गुड इज कॉल्ड प्राइवेट गुड इफ इट इज एलोकेटेड अंडर मार्केट मैकेनिज्म एंड अ पब्लिक और सोशल गुड cannot be provided by market mechanism. Another interesting phenomena connected to the concept of public good is free ridership, which means taking a ride without paying for it. Given the complication of free ridership, public goods may not be provided efficiently through market mechanism. In such a situation, Lindahl equilibrium may be used. The private mechanism for resource allocation depends on market demand and market supply curve for the private good. Moreover, the mechanism of provision of a private good is not applicable to a public good, as by definition of a public good, they are equally available to all, and even if individual demand curves are different, individuals cannot consume different amounts of public good. After studying this module, you shall be able to conceptually differentiate between a public good and a private good and analyze wide spectrum of goods that lie between pure public and pure private goods. You shall also be able to understand the concept of free ridership. Understand the concept and need of pseudo-demand curves and differentiate between partial and general equilibrium analysis. To understand allocation of a good, it is extremely important to understand the inherent characteristics of a good which make it public or private. A good is called private good if it is allocated under market mechanism. Market is the place where buyers and sellers come together. In case of private good, buyers reveal their demand curve. You shall also be able to understand the problem of allocating resources and private and public mechanism for allocating resources. Market demand curve is based on the marginal benefit they derive after consuming successive units of the good and is found by horizontally adding the individual demand curves for the private good under consideration. Sellers determine the supply based on marginal cost of providing the good. Equilibrium is established at the point of intersection between demand and supply curves. Equilibrium also represents a situation where marginal benefit to the private consumers is equal to the marginal cost of providing the good. In equilibrium condition, every consumer gets to consume the quantity he or she wants to consume at equilibrium price and according to his or her individual demand curve. Private good is also called as rival or subtractable because if one person is consuming it, others cannot consume the same good simultaneously. A public or social good cannot be provided by market mechanism. Main reason for this is the non-rivalry and non-excludability of the good. By definition, a public good is non-rival because even if one person is consuming it, the consumption does not affect the availability of good for anyone else. Examples of public goods are national defense, fresh air, street lights, etc. A road, public parking, a playground, etc. can be called as public goods, but they don't fall in the category of pure public goods. A road,
और पब्लिक पार्क मे बी इक्वली अवेलेबल टू एवरी वन बट ओवर क्राउडिंग विल मेक द कंजम्पशन राइवल. देयर आर गुड्स विच कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज बोथ प्राइवेट एज वेल एज पब्लिक. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लॉ एंड ऑर्डर एंड प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी कम इन पब्लिक डोमेन एंड हेंस विल बी कॉल्ड एज पब्लिक गुड्स. बट If an individual decides to hire a private guard to protect his property, protection can be called a private good. There are goods which by characteristic are non-rival in nature. For example, cable TV connection. Your TV transmission will not be affected by transmission of your neighbor, and hence the consumption is non-rival in nature. But the good is exploitable as only those people get the good which are willing to pay for it. Another interesting phenomena connected to the concept of public good is free ridership. As the name only suggests, it implies taking a ride without paying for it. As by definition, a public good is non-exploitable and non-rival in nature, people will avoid paying for it voluntarily. People will be aware that once the good is available, it will be equally available to all, even if they have not paid for it. Each of the consumers will have incentive to not reveal his willingness to pay by his demand curve because he expects that the good will be financed by those who will reveal their willingness to pay. And once the good is available, it will be equally available to all. Free ridership makes the allocation of public good extremely difficult because in this case there is no revealed demand curve. How the good should be priced and how much quantity of good should be produced becomes an extremely challenging question. Given the incentive to act as a free rider, it is unrealistic to assume that consumers will reveal their true demand for a public good. In this type of situation, theoretically, pseudo-demand curves are used. Pseudo-demand curves are similar to demand curves for public good, but are not exactly that. We may say that these are the demand curves which we unrealistically expect consumers to reveal. Let us explain the private mechanism for resource allocation. Let us take quantity of private good at x-axis and price at y-axis. Assuming that there are only two individuals living in economy, Mr. A and Mr. B, total market demand curve for the private good under consideration can be found by horizontally adding private demand curve of Mr. A and that of Mr. B. The point of intersection between demand and supply curves will give us market equilibrium as depicted by point E. In this case, Mr. A as well as Mr. B will pay the market price. If we notice individual demand curves of A and B, we will find that at a price corresponding to equilibrium point E, Mr. A will consume corresponding to the point where his individual demand curve, that is his marginal benefit curve, is equal to the prevailing market price. Same will hold true for Mr. B also. As in the diagram, we have taken Mr. A's demand curve to be lower than that of Mr. B. A will consume less at the given price compared to B. The total output produced will be equal to output being consumed by Mr. A plus output being consumed by Mr. B. Let us now look at the allocation of resources under public good mechanism. Public goods are equally available to all, even if individual demand curves are different. Individuals cannot consume different amounts of a public good. In this case, rather than horizontal addition, vertical addition of individual pseudo-demand curves of Mr. A and Mr. B is done. By vertically adding the individual pseudo-demand curves of Mr. A and Mr. B, total demand curve for the social good can be estimated. In this case also, we are assuming a normal upward sloping supply curve. The demand curve intersects the supply curve at E. Total output produced will be equal to output being consumed by Mr. A, which will also be equal to output being consumed by Mr. B. Point E will not only show us total quantity of public good to be produced, which would be consumed by everyone, it will also give us total price of public good. Therefore, price of public good is equal to price paid by Mr. A plus price paid by Mr. B. Using the individual demand curves of Mr. A and Mr. B, one can conclude about the contribution of each person towards the total cost of supplying the social good. But as stated earlier, the demand curves are pseudo-demand curves. One must not forget that a social good is not sold in the market. So openly, demand will not be revealed and very little information is available on the slope as well as position of such demand curves. Given the complication of free ridership, public goods may not be provided efficiently through market mechanism. In such a situation, Eric Lindahl in 1919 presented a solution called as Lindahl equilibrium, shown in the figure. According to his solution, people will voluntarily come forth to provide for the cost of public good given their demand curves and their knowledge of others' demand curves. Let us explain the solution with the help of a diagram. We are retaining assumption of having two individuals, Mr. A and Mr. B, and one social good. Demand curve DD shows Mr. A's demand curve for a particular public good. The vertical axis measures the share of the public goods cost that he will have to pay. DBDB is Mr. B's demand curve. OE is the equilibrium level of output whose cost will be shared by A and B according to their demand schedules. For output levels greater than OE, people are not willing to pay the total cost of the good. Output level OE is a Lindahl equilibrium, which is a balance between people's demand for public goods and the tax shares that each must pay for them. It is extremely important to understand the difference between partial equilibrium and general equilibrium. Partial equilibrium analysis focuses only on a part of the market, assuming other things to remain same. Compared to partial equilibrium, general equilibrium is a detailed framework where focus is on entire economy. Present analysis is based on the assumptions. Number one, there are two goods in the economy, one private good P and one social good S, taken on y-axis and x-axis respectively. And number two, production possibility curve for two goods P and S is given. Production possibility curve or PPC, also called as transformation function or production frontier, shows the possibilities open for increasing the output of one good by reducing the output of other. Next assumption is that the tastes of the consumers are given. That is, we have utility map for Mr. A as well as for Mr. B. To show efficient allocation of a social good in general equilibrium framework, first we select a given level of utility for individual A, which is depicted by his indifference curve ICA. Subtracting it vertically from the transformation curve, we get another curve known as residual curve or consumption curve for B. This consumption curve will reveal the maximum private good available for B given A's utility level. Out of various options of private good available for B, B will choose that point where residual curve touches its highest indifference curve. In the figure, ICB2 is that indifference curve and E is the equilibrium for B. Corresponding to E, Mr. A will choose a point like K on his indifference curve as point of consumption, K being exactly vertical to E. It is important to note here that both A as well as B will be consuming same amount of public good which can be found. In case of private good, it will not be so. In partial equilibrium approach, existence of other good or goods is ignored and goods price is seen in terms of money. Characteristic of a partial equilibrium approach is the assumption that some things like other prices that conceivably could change do not change. Partial equilibrium analysis therefore tend to ignore some of the interrelationships among prices and markets. By contrast, in a general equilibrium analysis, all goods and prices are considered variable and the analysis focuses on the simultaneous determination of equilibrium in all markets.
Let us now summarize what we have learnt in this module. A good is called private good if it is allocated under market mechanism. Market is the place where buyers and sellers come together. In case of private good, buyers reveal their demand curve. At the other end, a public or social good cannot be provided by market mechanism. Main reason for this is non-rivalry and non-excludability of the good. By definition, a public good is non-rival because even if one person is consuming it, the consumption does not affect the availability of the good for anyone else. As explained earlier also, private mechanism for resource allocation depends upon market demand and market supply curve for the private good. Assuming that there are only two individuals living in the economy, total market demand curve for the private good under consideration can be found by horizontally adding private demand curve of both. The mechanism of provision of a private good is not applicable to a public good as by definition, once provided, goods are equally available to all, and even if individual demand curves are different, individuals cannot consume different amounts of a public good. In this case, rather than horizontal addition, vertical addition of the individual pseudo demand curves is done. Given the complication of free ridership, public goods may not be provided efficiently through market mechanism. In such a situation, Lindahl equilibrium may be used. According to his solution, people will voluntarily come forth to provide for the cost of public good given their demand curves and their knowledge of others' demand curves. To show efficient allocation of a social good in general equilibrium framework, first we select a given level of utility for individual A to get another curve known as residual curve for B. Out of various options of private good available for B, B will choose that point where residual curve touches its highest indifference curve. In equilibrium, both A as well as B will be consuming same amount of public good but different amounts of private good.